Hi folks, today I'm going to be reviewing Speed Dial 800. So here you can see the toy. It transforms into a fairly convincing 1-to-1 scale mobile phone. Not based on any particular model that I'm aware of, but at a distance and at a glance it is fairly convincing, and I've actually managed to fool quite a few people pretending to use this phone, and at a glance it does actually look quite real. Of course, on closer inspection you can tell it's a toy. Another trans fan remarked to me that these Real Gear robots really do have a micro change feel to them. A lot of the early Transformers, or some of the early Transformers, were derived from Micro Man's Micro Change subline, which was also made by Takara, and they were supposed to represent robots that transformed into 1-to-1 scale objects that you can find. For example, some of them would transform into mini cars when these became the Autobot mini cars. Others would transform into cassette players, which became Sound Raven Blaster, or micro cassettes, which were, of course, the Decepticon and Autobot cassettes. And of course, Megatron was also from the Micro Change line, transforming into more or less a 1-to-1 scale Warthor P-38. So the Real Gear robots really harked back to that age. The play value of this toy is that it looks like a, more or less looks like a replica phone. As I mentioned before, I have actually fooled some people with this, you know, at a glance, because it does look real. On the sides you can see some buttons here, one here for volume control, another here to activate the camera. On the back you can actually see a camera lens. The lens is transparent, so it actually looks fairly convincing. On the front you can see a small display screen, LCD display screen, showing the time. It's permanently set at 7:47 PM. And also has an Autobot insignia in there. The other toy is mostly grey, with a metallic blue sort of stripe happening here with a silver circle. Toy flipped open, you can see here, looks like a fairly standard flip open kind of mobile phone that you see in models such as Motorola. It's got the keypad here, fairly standard for most mobile phones. Typical menu buttons, and of course the main display screen, complete with a wallpaper that has the Autobot insignia in the middle of it, and the time. It even has bars that tell you how much battery power and the reception strength, as well as the menu and select options. So the sort of typical things you would find on a mobile phone screen. Up here we've got the speaker, the earpiece, okay, which is obviously there for when you're using the phone. So the typical things you would usually find. Alright, let's take this thing to robot mode. So the first thing we do is to lower these two portions here so that they form the rudimentary legs, like so, and we turn them this way. Okay, we then take this top part here and rotate it about 180 degrees and drop it to the back here. We flip out the feet from underneath the legs, of course, and the sides of the phone we bring down to form the arms, flip out the claws, and we bring the shoulders up and position the arms as you please. Okay, and finally we open these two panels here to reveal the robot face. So there you have it, Speed Dial 800 robot mode. It's fairly well articulated. It's interesting how they've used the part of the keypad to form the torso, bringing the robot mode a bit more colour to what would otherwise be a fairly bland grey form. So it gives you sort of a silver accent across the chest, and of course you can place his nipples to answer or hang up on a call. Let's not mention what happens when you dial 000. He's got more black accents in the now revealed robot parts, as well as deep metallic blue for the forearms and a metallic electric blue for the face. Okay. Otherwise, the colors are the same as the phone mode. And an interesting feature is that the camera lens has become his cycloptic eye. So, like G1 Shockwave, he shares a similar problem of having no depth perception. Ooh, poor guy. The robot mode is otherwise fairly well articulated. One of his arm joints are ball joints, and his hips have a double swivel joint, so he can strike a number of fairly cool action poses. Ka-chow, ka-chow! So that's my review of Speed Dial 800. He's a fairly nifty figure. A lot of the play value, aside from being a Transformer, comes from the fact that he does transform into a replica mobile phone, which you can use as a role-playing toy. And there's a massive amount of fun to be had there for those of us who, you know, remember playing with G1 Soundwave and Megatron as scale replicas as well. My only main complaint of the Real Gears line are the names that Hasbro has assigned to these toys. They're like some of the worst names I've seen since Robots in Disguise. The terrible thing about the Real Gear robot names is they all sound like they kind of handle some AOL using Lamo would use, and, you know, come and flame you or troll you on some message board. Really, you can take any Real Gear robot name and attach at AOL.com onto it, and you can imagine them logging on and saying, "Oh, ASL! I am one lead hacksaw. LOL 1111111111." All right. So in this case, it's speeddial800@AOL.com. You can imagine this guy in the IRC chat room, you know, trying to hit onto all the girls. It's just the name is very unfortunate. If they'd only removed the 800, then, you know, just Speed Dial on its own would have been a better name than Speed Dial 800. Aside from the terrible name, as I said before, it's a fairly good toy, and it's pretty fun, and I would recommend picking it up.